all, by trying to move towards standard terms and terminology. I'm not yet talking about a standard, but really making sure that people mean the same thing when they talk about the same thing. So a consistent set of definitions with some flexibility at the country level, and also trying to make sure that we find a way to respect and or translate into national classifications. We need a code of conduct for funders and CSO to promote this. And I think that what we've just seen, this Malawi rating of how compliant and effective the donors are, is a very good system, because nobody likes to see themselves at the bottom of a list. So this is a very good incentive for donors to essentially act according to whatever code of conduct there will be. And what the countries wanted is a standard data reporting format, so that, again, reduction of transaction costs, so we can actually begin to see the materialization of the benefits that Owen talked about at the beginning of the session. And by establishing these systems, we also develop and strengthen the country-level processes, and hence facilitate the use of country systems, which are such an important part of the Accra Agenda for Action. So what needs to be done? What we have learned in those two countries is obviously useful, but the sample is too small. So what I think needs to be done now is to find more countries that would like to receive visits from the IATI group, and really begin to not simply understand what their needs are, but road test the standard, road test some definitions, and to see in real time how things can be done, in a practical way. And in the meantime, there will be the side benefit of building capacity and strengthening the processes that are already on the ground. It's important, this is an early conclusion, that donors begin to think of their information system at the local level with providing more forward-looking information and measurable impact. I think what Richard reminded us about the impact of not having that information on two restrictive fiscal programs in the 80s and the 90s should be a reminder to all of us that this forward-looking information is absolutely essential. Now, this needs an investment of people, time, and inputs, and this is the cost that Owen talked about in the beginning. And we also need, and this is a role for information technology, we need to build the tools for making the best possible use of this information. At the country level, aid information management systems, you've seen the example of Malawi, and this afternoon I believe we will talk a little bit more about the aid management system that the Development Gateway offers, and that will give us a sense of what's happening in the countries that are using it. And we also talked about the need to have a place where civil society, researchers, journalists would be able to look at the data that will be gathered through this way, and again, a global portal that will complement the CRS will be important. In sum, I think that what we have learned in these two pilots is that there is in the countries a demand for timeliness, for consistency, for transparency, and for forward-looking information. That is not a surprise, but it has been amply confirmed by the visits. To meet this challenge and this demand, IIT must add value in two ways, at the partner country level and at the global level. At the partner country level, IIT could help reduce transaction costs, and we've seen the benefits that Owen has begun to calculate. It will empower governments to plan and to manage their aid more effectively, and it will enhance local donor coordination and enforce a code of conduct such as it will be. At the global level, I think the ability to aggregate IAT compliant data will be a very important complement to the CRS, which in many ways remains the standard, by improving timeliness, coverage of the non-DAC donors and some of the new donors, the foundations, sometimes playing a very important role, and aligning with the fiscal years of the countries. It will permit accountability by allowing an easy tracking and monitoring of global commitments. It's very nice that the G8 and now the G20 are making commitments, but very, very little is being done to actually allow those who need to hold the promise makers accountable to have information. So I think it would be very important to have a database where people can do this and try to have accessibility of this database at the village level, what Jeff Gutman said yesterday. And with the development in information technology, with the wiki, with the Web 2.0 tools, we can begin to imagine that villagers can be able to report what they see in their village through a database of that sort. And for those who need to find out what works in aid, such information will make it possible for meaningful analysis and for learning from what we do. I'll stop here. Thank you.